One of my dear friends was the famous poet James Dillett Freeman. He actually married my wife and I. This was written by him. There are many kinds of stillness. There is the ice-locked stillness of a winter lake. There is the stillness of the lake in summer, where small birds sing, and the wind washes small waves softly on the shore. There is also the stillness of the lake that is your mind. When in your prayers you listen, not to your own words or thoughts, but for the still, small voice of God. The world in which we live is filled with sounds that we have learned to accept as normal. But a moment of God-centered silence can be a much-needed blessing. Today, let us seek the power that is to be found in the silence. Let us consciously tune out the external sounds and, in confidence and faith, tune to the creative silence at the heart of us. In times of quiet meditation, we experience a vitalizing communication with God's life-giving presence. Let us joyfully take the time and welcome the opportunity for a moment of inspiring, God-centered silence. In this silence, we relax all tension, we calm all thought, we quiet all distractions. In this God-centered silence, we are open to divine order and peace. God's creative silence imparts to us a new sense of direction, a new sense of strength, and a new level of quiet trust and faith. As it says in the Bible in Isaiah, "In returning and rest, you shall be saved. In quietness and in trust shall be your strength."